Hi, Sudis. How are you doing? Welcome to Naya Sim, and thank you all so much for all the love and support. Hope you all are doing great. I came across a video that looks like she is gaslighting, but then it is what it is. We are going to set this video together, and what she was talking about is that why is it that nobody can correct a black woman? And I am asking how. What do you mean that nobody can correct a black woman? You know, a lot of people actually stitch the video something. She's rage baiting something. She's gaslighting, being manipulative, because I personally see that video like she is being very manipulative, right? See, nobody is above correction. Anybody can correct people. But why correcting people? People should also do that in love and with respect, right? And she went further to say that why is it that black men cannot correct a black woman, white people cannot correct black women? So who is that person that can correct them? Because this seems like they do not want to be corrected and the rest of it. I mean, that is coming from her. It's a little bit shocking because I don't know how people jump into discussions like this and then conclude and saying that a lot of people need correction and all that. I am not saying that it's not wrong, but sometimes I hope people understand that being corrected or being, people do not want to be corrected and that it's okay. People do not want you in their business and that it's okay. But looking for a way to get yourself into somebody's business, hope you know it's kind of you being nosy. Let's get into this.
Let me start this video by saying I am being sincere. I genuinely want to know. I am making this video so I can gain an understanding. So no one can question black women. No one can correct black women. No one can offer information and advice to black women. Nobody. And I know you're probably thinking, Ash, where are you going with this? This is not a question. I see so many women come onto this app, not all, but some, a lot, to be honest, and say they're having a problem with something. And you will have people offer advice, and they will say, no, that's not it. People will make videos where they are blatantly wrong in what they did, and people will come and say, you're asking if you're right or wrong. We're here to tell you that you're wrong. No, I'm not. You will have people that will make a video. Example, I'm never approached by men. What am I doing wrong? Well, maybe you're not approachable. No, you're wrong. Help me to understand who can say anything to black women. If black women can't critique and correct black women, black men cannot critique and correct black women, because you need to stay out of women's business. We know the counterparts can't say anything, which I understand. Who can? I'm just trying to figure this out, because no matter what content that I put out, it is always with the greatest of intent to help improve my community. Now, we may not always agree, and I respect that. But why is it that everything that I say is looked at as a negative? It's looked at as I'm being a pick me. It's looked at like, you don't know what you're talking about. Okay, so when the black men come and say, hey, ladies, y'all are saying that y'all are having problem with black men, here's why. No, it's not. Who can correct us? I genuinely want to know. I genuinely want to hear what y'all got to say in the comment section. So no one can question black women. Who can correct us? I genuinely want to know.
Okay, aside from the fact that you're asking a question where the black women can be questioned while you're asking the question, asking to black women so they can answer the question, while you're asking the question, while you're also asking if you can ask the question, while you ask the question. I'm just going to go with you on that. Okay, I'm going to go with you on that. And I'm going to get the answer for you. And I'm going to get that answer by questioning black women, okay? And you can answer in the comments, black women, to these questions I'm about to ask to black women, okay? Okay, black women, did you rest today? You find a moment of peace. Were you able to give yourself grace that the world denies you? Boom. How's therapy? And by that, I mean, how's your therapist? Are they the best because you deserve the best? Are they adequate in meeting your needs? Because I know you spend all that money on therapy. Okay. Did you eat? Find a moment to nourish yourself, care for yourself, make yourself a priority today before the demands of the world to save everybody else, save everybody else. Did you think of yourself today? Okay. How's your journey with vulnerability and the lack of safe spaces the world provides for that? And what can we do to facilitate as a collective group to make safe spaces for each other, to express our vulnerability? When the world demands so much of you, when the world demands so much of you and holding you to all account, every corner, every turn, questioning you, your hair, your body, the tone of your voice, what do you do? Black women, what do you do? What parts of your humanity was denied today? And how can we work out ways to not internalize that level of degradation for ourselves? Because you deserve humanity. You deserve humanity however you show up in the world. You do know that, right? You know that, Pooh. Do you? Okay. And last but not least, out of all the questions that I've asked, my last question, Black women, for you, is did you tell them people to kiss your ass today? Have you taken a moment to do that, babe? Okay. Now, with all that being said, with all those questions that I just asked, I'll see if we can actually question Black women by the responses I get in my comments. Because at the end of the day, I don't think it's whether you can question Black women. I think your issue is the questions, not whether you can or you can't. I don't think you want answers to questions. I don't think you want accountability when you ask this question. I think you want to see Black women punished even more than the world already does. I think that's what it is. Also, when you ask this question, I'm pretty sure you're just bored. Also, the way this app works, it's just rage bait. Adding on to the world's hate for Black women. So the extra point question for Black women. Have you found ways to tell the world to go to hell today? Okay. I know a lot of us already do, but some of us seem to be out there in the blue. So for those that are still a little bit confused, what are you doing to make safe spaces of vulnerability with each other to talk?
No one can question Black women. No one can correct Black women.
You know, I may not come when y'all want me to, but I'm always going to be on time. So let's address this BS. Okay? Because the irony that you're a Black woman asking this question of whether or not Black women can be questioned, can be challenged, can be called out for things, and now you're getting questioned and challenged and called out for this take is not lost on me. Now, everybody already told you behind that this is BS because yes, mama, yes, Black women can and are called out. We are questioned. To be quite honest, we are the most heavily scrutinized while also being the most heavily imitated women on the planet. They literally put metal devices in our mouths when we first got here to prevent us from speaking. They created Ting Yong laws because white women were jealous that their white men were looking at our hair, so they made us cover it up. Everybody want to know what Black women are doing, why we're doing it, how we're doing it. Remember that white dude that said around Thanksgiving a couple of years back that he followed some old Black woman around the grocery store just to see what seasoning she was picking up, and then he picked up the same stuff that he can make his dinner? Instead of asking, can Black women be questioned for things, you need to be wondering why Black women are questioned all the goddamn time. To be honest, we have to play 21 questions just to get justice, and most of the time we don't even get it after answering all the questions correctly. Not only are Black women questioned for our own actions, we are questioned for the actions of our entire community. When Black men are out here cutting up, they don't go to the men and the fathers and ask them what's wrong. They come to the Black mother, the Black woman, and ask us how we failed them. When other demographics of women are out here fucking up the political landscape for the rest of the fucking country, Black women are the ones that are asked all the time to do something about it. We have been charged with raising this country, birthing this country, giving our last drop of milk to this country at the expense of our own Black children. Yet you want to ask the internet, can Black women be challenged or questioned about their behavior? Quite frankly, I don't think Black women are cutting up enough. Black women have at least 300-400 years of acting a damn fool that we deserve, but are not allowed to even have because we are still held to a higher standard than everybody else. What you're really wondering is why black women are starting to act like we don't care anymore when people challenge and question us. And the truth is, we're sick and tired of it. We don't care no more that you don't like that we're not moving the way that y'all want us to move. We don't care no more that these other women and other races are mad at us because we won't save their ass from their bad decisions. We don't care anymore. That's the real problem. See, we used to be shamed into doing things for y'all when y'all challenged us and questioned us and called us out. Now we're not holding ourselves responsible for what these black men do. Now we're not holding ourselves responsible for what goes wrong in this country or in this world. We are resting in our femininity and living our best black lives, and we're letting y'all burn. And it's weird that as another black woman, you don't see it. Black women do not have to be questioned about anything. Black women do not owe you an explanation about everything that we do and do not do. Maybe you as another black woman are still answering to people for the stuff that you do and you're confused that you didn't get the memo, but baby, we have moved on from that. Catch up.
Let me start this video by saying I am being sincere. I genuinely want to know. I am making this video so I can gain an understanding. So no one can question black women.
So I find when people start a video about black women with, I genuinely want to understand, typically the video is neither genuine nor an effort to actually seek understanding about anything. So she goes on to ask the question of who can correct black women. And the question itself was something I had to sit with, because at first take, I was just irritated. Then I took a minute. I said, okay, Evie, dial it back. You know, maybe this is worth having a conversation about. So let's just unpack it a little bit. Now, this is a conversation that I've had with lots of friends that I have. And my friends include beautifully educated, amazing black women from all different walks of life. These are mothers. These are professionals. These are truly talented and amazing human beings, right? And I'm fortunate to call them my inner circle. And this is a conversation we have regularly. But you know what that means? That means that this woman is not really surrounding herself with the right people. When you surround yourself with black women, good, genuine, loving, caring, smell so good black women, they hold each other accountable all the time. They correct each other all the time. They give advice all the time, and it is received. And you know why it's received? Because of the intention behind it. When a woman who looks like you, who has been through something similar as you, who is walking through life experiencing the same things that you experience, offers you advice, or tells you that there is something that they see that you may not, you listen and you take it to heart. Why? Because you know that it is coming from a genuinely good and decent and intentionally positive space. Whether it's good advice, bad advice, finds you in a good space, a bad space, makes you think, makes you happy, whatever it is, because you know the intention behind it, you receive. I feel like this question also makes us pay attention to the fact that we're not looking at the psychological state of black women, especially in this country. I can't speak to other countries because maybe I didn't grow up there. But from the moment a black woman is conceived in this country, she is questioned. She's still in the womb, okay? And people are asking, where's the father? What's the home life like? Who's the mother? How did this come to be? How old is she? Is she married? Is this going to be a two-parent household? Ooh, I hope she's not going to perpetuate stereotypes. Hopefully she turned out better than her mother did. Who's going to help raise that babe? Then she comes out and she's critiqued on what she looks like, who she looks like, who she favors. I wonder what her upbringing is going to be like. Then she's in diapers and start walking, and she starts feeling the real effects. Tell her, being told how to walk, how to talk, how to dress. Don't be too fast. Now, because that's going to get you in trouble, when being fast can simply be how she walks and who she chooses to play with on the playground. Then she gets into school, and there are teachers, principals, coaches, everybody that is going to critique and have advice and have something to say about every facet of her life. And she's expected to internalize that, keep her head down, and do what she is told so that she doesn't appear one way or another. Then you get into the workplace and you get bosses, people who think that they are your boss, okay, even though they're on the same pay level as you, that have something to say about how you present yourself, what clothes you wear, how you wear your hair, whether or not you wear makeup. Do you wear too much makeup? Should you wear more makeup? Should you be quiet in a meeting? You don't want to come off angry. You don't want to come off opinionated. You don't want to be that black woman, all while supposedly walking through life with a smile on your face and being ready to face the world with a positive attitude. Then you've got people around you that want to critique every relationship you get into, how you carry yourself when you're not in a workplace. Oh, don't be that way and you a mother. Oh, don't be that way if you want to be a wife. Oh, don't be that way or society's going to think something of you, and if anything happens, it's going to be your fault. Then we have literal laws that tell us how to wear our hair and how to present ourselves. Don't be too proud, because if you're too proud, then you're causing problems with others, and it's going to be an issue. Don't forget to smile, because you don't want to walk down the street looking too angry, because then once again, you're perpetuating a stereotype. Then you got men who tell you how to be a woman. You got women who tell you how to keep a man. And the cycle just goes on and on and on. I could do this all day long. But my point in all of this is to ask the genuine question of who can correct black women. Be fucking for real. Everybody corrects black women. Everybody has something to say about black women. Everybody has an opinion every single day about every single thing that a black woman does from the moment her 2 feet hit this earth till she is 6 feet under. And to try to say anything other when you're walking around this world as a black woman is real, real weird. We don't spend enough time dissecting what living like that does to a black woman and why it changes how she sees the world and how she carries herself in this world. But yet we want to tell her, oh, nobody can say nothing to you. Everybody is saying something to me, sis. Everybody. Take a number at this point. So to say you genuinely have this question and you genuinely want to know, it's nothing genuine about it. That's clickbait, baby. But that's okay, because it's late at night and I'm scrolling and I got time. I'm getting ready to go to bed. So I'm going to just finish by saying, black women, I love y'all. I love y'all to my core. I love everything about you. And if ain't nobody done told you today, you don't got to listen to what nobody got to say. That ain't coming from a genuine place. Ain't nobody got no autonomy over your life but you. You will have all of the amazing things in the world because I am rooting for you every single day. Every time you put 2 feet on the floor, you are killing the game and you are defying everything the devil has tried to put in front of you. I love y'all. The question of who can correct black women, be fucking for real. Everybody corrects black women. Everybody has something to say about black women. Everybody has an opinion every single day about every single thing that a black woman does from the moment her 2 feet hit this earth till she is 6 feet under. And to try to say anything other when you're walking around this world as a black woman is real, real.
But are they listening? If everybody has something to say about black women and everybody is correcting black women and everybody is critiquing black women, why is it that some black women, not all, why is it that so many black women are having such a problem in life? Could it be that they're not listening? Could it be that they're not applying the advice? Could it be that they are so headstrong that I'm gonna do things the way I want to do it and still failing? And instead of realizing, dang, I'm messing this up. It's somebody else's fault because it can't be me because, you know, I'm the blueprint. I'm not saying that's what this woman said. I'm going to make a point to tag her in this video so y'all can go and watch her entire video because everything she said is true. Black women are policed and critiqued. Black women are judged and their opinions are criticized all the time. I agree. But there are some black women that listen, take heed, learn, improve, and move on. And there are some black women that have decided that they have this God complex, like nobody can check me, boo. I can do what I want to do when I want to do it. But then they cry about the results. Because the whole point of me making that original video was asking when people solicit for advice and they ask for public opinion and people give their opinion, and they fight those opinions and those critiques and those pieces of advice, then who can correct them? If you are a black woman that got your life together, you got your stuff together, you are confident and secure in yourself, you have the friend circle around you that is encouraging you to be your best, this didn't apply to you. This was not a video for you. Women who got good heads on their shoulders, they don't typically look for advice from strangers. But the women who don't have the support system, they didn't have the mom, the auntie, the cousin, they aren't in the best of environments, they need advice. And if I'm not here to give it, or you, ma'am, are not here to give it, and they don't have a friend group, they don't have family, who's gonna give it? Because apparently nobody can correct them because they're the blueprint and can't nobody tell me what to do. Okay, and that's fine. Well, stop coming on this app crying about how horrible your life is and how bad parenting is and how you tired of being broke and how you can't find a good man. No, no, no. Sit in them consequences because that's what you wanted. Remember, nobody can tell you anything. If everybody has something to say about black women and everybody is correcting black women and everybody is critiquing black women, why is it that some black women, not all, why is it that so many black women are having such a problem in life?
when people start a video about black women with, I genuinely...
Number one problem with the women of today is this right here. The use of the word correction is rubbed me the wrong way. It implies we're inherently wrong and I don't like it. That sounds like an immature adult.
About black women with, I genuinely want to understand.
This lady goes on to make a video that doesn't hold black women accountable to the fact that for the past 40 years we've been retrogressing as a group of women.
From just make a video asking you, do you mean every single black woman? Why didn't she give you the benefit of the doubt?
Hey y'all, so as you can see, my last video has elicited quite a few think pieces from both the original creator and quite a few men, basically calling me out and saying that I'm delusional, I'm dangerous to society, my mindset is why black women are not progressing. There's tons in the comments saying the same thing, basically saying that though I am a black woman and these are my lived experiences and these are my thoughts, they are not valid, right? And while it would be easy to fall into the trap of the back and forth, to call out the lack of communication, the lack of healing, the overall disdain for black women, the clickbait behavior for us to talk about the lack of communication between the sexes, to fall into all of the rigmarole that can be pulled out by these kinds of conversations. Instead of doing all of that and calling people to the carpet, I'm instead going to comment on this. This gentleman said the better question would have been, who will you listen to? And that, I feel like, when asked in a genuine manner, is a way to actually start a very necessary conversation. So for me, who I will listen to is a very simple answer, I think. And that's people I trust. People that I trust. So if my accountant comes to me and says, Evie, you're making poor money decisions, I trust that and I make the necessary changes. If my mother comes to me and says that she feels like I'm moving in a way that is unsavory, I trust that. If my husband comes to me and says that things in the household are not going how he needs them to go, I trust that and make some changes. If my grandmother comes to me, she is my spiritual center. If she comes to me and says something is not aligning, something doesn't feel right, I think that you should do XYZ, I trust that and I move accordingly. If my friends, who happen to be an amazing group of women and a great amazing group of mothers, comes to me and say that they see that my child is going astray, I trust that and I make the necessary changes. I solicit their advice, take it to heart, and see how I can apply it for the betterment of my situation. And all of those things are predicated on intention. These are all people that have positive intentions over the things that they're saying, even if what they say hurts my feelings, even if it makes me mad, even if it makes me take a look in the mirror and it's not what I want to do. The fact that they are coming to me with that intention and I trust them, I take it. And it seems like, looking at the comments, that seems to be the general consensus. It's not that black women can't be corrected, because there seems to be a lot of discourse around the word corrected and what the actual definition of it is. The fact of it is, you can't correct somebody if they don't trust you. That advice and that correction is a privilege. Allowing someone into your space to speak over your life is a privilege, and it comes with a level of humility. And so when strangers feel like they can speak on your life and say things a certain way, that intention, that humility is not there. So you don't receive it well. It also goes back to tone. It depends on the delivery and the tone of the person that is coming to you. If somebody is super rah-rah and comes to you talking crazy about what you need to do with their life, or they're speaking to you in such a way that is elevating them and belittling or degrading you because of your circumstance, you're not going to receive it, which is how a lot of information is given to black women. It is always made to make them feel shame. It's made to make them feel angry. It's made to make them feel less than. So they don't receive it well. I will wrap all of this up by saying that it's a necessary conversation. It is a positive conversation. It can be a positive conversation. But I find that whenever it comes to the topic of black women, people use us as a scapegoat for clickbait, for views, for rage. And it never really is having the intention of healing, which is what needs to take place. There has to be a healing that goes into the communication that we exchange back and forth. And that's never what it comes down to. It's always a bash black women section. Look at some of my comments. Look at her original comments. Look at the people who responded to me and how they responded to me. Instead of discounting my personal experience and my thoughts, none of them chose to engage and say, hey, you know what? I see your perspective. I see how you feel. Why do you feel that way? What in your day-to-day experience makes you feel that way? Validate the fact that I am walking through life as a black woman instead of telling me what the black woman experience was. That didn't happen. It's this is what I think, this is what I feel, you need to take it. And that's part of the problem that I'm seeing in this entire discourse. So thank you for this comment, Jay Mr. 1503. I appreciate you for asking the correct question. I hope that that answered your question from me. You can read some of the comments and other people's responses, because they also answered the question. And again, black women, I love y'all. I love y'all so much. I hope y'all had a great day.
So this is all I got from this video, and sincerely speaking, I really don't understand where she's coming from, because she's not really making a great point. Number one is that as an adult, you have your own life to live. You do not expect people to tell you what to do and what not to do. I mean, you make mistakes yourself, you correct yourself, and you move on. And the truth is that everybody is allowed to correct people, but in a respectful way. You don't come and want to correct people and you are disrespectful, because I probably would think that you do not have anything great to say, right? When you want to correct people, you correct them, like, you know, or you correct them well, not coming to probably bash them or make them feel like they are less of themselves before saying what you want to say and the rest of it. Everybody can correct Black women, but why is it that it's only Black women that everybody has got opinion to say? Everybody got something they want to say about Black women. And then I think she's just gaslighting, because she went for that to say that, white people cannot correct Black women, Black men cannot correct Black women and all that. So who can correct them? I mean, why I said that she is just gaslighting is because she said that some people do not have mom and all that and they need people to lead them. Shut the hell up. My dad, you know, when my dad died when I was younger, right? And I got my mom, right? Do I need my uncles to come and tell me you are supposed to do this, you're supposed to do that? No. I already have a heart. Having a heart is just something that everybody need, because your heart tells you if this is right and this is not wrong. Sometimes you might be a little bit confused that you need directions and all that, which you can go for, like, you know, going for direction. But you do not expect everybody to have opinion, or you do not also expect me to listen to what everybody is saying. And because she gave me advice does not mean that that advice would be valuable to me. Or even if you gave me advice, if I apply it, it may not still work, right? So let people do them and stop coming online to gaslight yourself and other people, because that doesn't make any sense. You all have something to say. Not until it gets to you, then you are dumb or you are quiet and you cannot say anything. Right? Everybody is, you can correct anybody you want to correct. There is nobody that is not supposed to correct anybody. But coming here to, I don't know, the way she started it like she is coming to fight, right? And because, like, everybody's always talking about, everybody wants to say, so they have something they want to say about Black women and all that. So for that reason, let me use that opportunity to come in and drop my own pew-pew and run away. And that pew-pew will go back to you, because I don't understand what you are saying. Is she even like it? Because she's even talking like she is quarreling, like she has somebody that she got on mind that she needs to, release whatever she has in her heart so that, I don't know what to say, bro. You are headed, right? So, man, you are heard from every other person said. But for me, I think she's just gaslighting. She's just being manipulating. See you all in my next video. Bye for now.